Daniel, the 5th chapter. And I'm going to begin reading at the 22nd verse. The Bible said, and the Philistines came up yet again and spread themselves in the valley of Rephaim. Oh yeah, the valley of Rephaim is where, Shabbat. If you research Rephaim, you'll find out that that represents, hallelujah, God, Goliath. It is a city and a place where giants live. Rephaim means giant. There were giant peoples in the land. David had already fought the Goliath when he was a young man. But there was something about this Goliath and the people of Goliath called Rephaim. They were really big giants that just wouldn't leave David alone. God said, what did God's word say in 2 Samuel the 5th chapter? In the 22nd verse, he said, in the valley of Rephaim, and when David inquired of the Lord, he said, thou shalt not go up, but fetch a compass behind thee, and come up on them over against the mulberry tree. Isn't it amazing how God will show you how to come up against the defense of your devil, come up on the defense of your enemy. He said, thou shalt not go up right now, David, but fetch a compass behind thee, a compass behind thee. He said, and come up on them over against the mulberry tree, and let it be when thou hearest the sound of it going in the top of the mulberry tree, that then thou shalt be certain thyself, then thou shalt be steer thyself, for then shall the Lord go up over before thee to smite the host of the Philistine. Now wait. Let me stop right there. What is God saying right now? God is saying, if you do what's good for you, if you do what's good for the goose and good for the gander, you will call upon the spirit of the mulberry tree. Come on, y'all, and pray right now. He said, call upon the spirit of the mulberry tree, and I'll meet you over in that place. And the Bible said that when you hear the sound, when you hear the sound of the mulberry tree, come on, y'all, running on the top of the mulberry tree. Come on, y'all, when you hear the spirit of God running up on the tree. The valley of Rephaim. You better stand up and talk to the demon of Rephaim. The demon of Rephaim is Shabbat, your God. The demon of Rephaim is, hey, my God. The demon of Rephaim is Shabbat, your God. It is that great big old Goliath. That Goliath that's standing inside of your way. Let that devil know I ain't worried about Rephaim. I let the devil know at TSA, I ain't worried about no Rephaim. But I'm getting ready to run on this plane, because my plane is going to make a sound of the Lord. The sound of the Lord is the wings of the shadow. And I'm going to get on the wings of the shadow of God. And I'm getting on this airplane and I'm coming to Boston. Ain't no devil going to shout by your God. Intimidate me, make me back up or stay down. But I'm looking for the mulberry tree. And when I hear the sound of that engine roar, I know it's time for me to stand up in that end there. Stand up and stand still when you're trying and doing all that you can do. Stand still in the sound of the mulberry tree when you're doing that all that you can do. Stand still in the sound of the mulberry tree. And I ran across the mulberry tree. I'm obedient at his word. I'm going to stand by the sound. And God said, get you a compass and put it behind you. The compass is the direction of the Holy Ghost. Y'all don't want to pray with me right now. God told David to get you a compass. Put my direction behind you. When I was in the military and we got lost, we pulled out our compass. If you get lost in that thing, all you got to do is pull out your direction. If you get lost in that thing, all you got to do is pull, hey, my God. Pull out your instruction, baby, and stand still by the mulberry bush. Stand still by the Holy Ghost. Stand still by the power. The power in the upper room. The power that was endued upon high. Stand by. Stand by. sound in the room. The sound.